and gentlemen, welcome to the Live, Love, we're not coming in like that.
Oh, we're not?
No, we're not. We're coming in like this. How y'all doing? Welcome to the Live, Love, and Laugh Show. I'm your host, Terry Higgins, giving you a little different flavor today. Ladies and gentlemen, we got a great show for you today, man. Great show. Let me catch my breath because I'm old. I can't be rocking out like that. I'm a 41-year-old man. I can't be rocking out like that. I'm not a teenager no more. Anyway, this story is on the one and only Marilyn Manson. Yes, Marilyn Manson, you know, the hardcore rock star heavy. I don't know, man. I don't even know. Is he considered heavy metal or just rock star? Anyway, look, man. Marilyn Manson has his hands full again. Now, you know, he has the history of a history of abusing women physically, mentally, sexually. Anyway, these are accusations. We don't know if these are true. Mr. Manson will have his day in court to fight these cases, but he has a new case. A lady by the name of Ashley Morgan Smithline has come out and accused him of the same thing that other women have accused him of in the past. Now, mind it, Marilyn Manson just got married. This brother just got married in October of last year. Now, Marilyn Manson does not look like the marrying type. This is his second marriage. He's been married before. And mind it, matter of fact, what's crazy is his ex-wife accused him of the same thing. His ex-wife, all of his exes, accused him of the same thing. He's a freakazoid. He's a psychopath. He's an abuser, sexually, mentally, physically, everything. Marilyn Manson. Now, mind it, Marilyn Manson looks like a crazy guy. Ladies, you got to pick your men better. You picked Marilyn Manson to be your boyfriend, your husband. This guy looks loose. He looks like a lunatic. He ain't wrapped too tight. When you got in a relationship with him, you should have known already this guy's not wrapped too tight. This guy's like this all the time. I've never seen Marilyn Manson anything other than Marilyn Manson. Now, mind it, his real name is not Marilyn Manson. His real name is Brian Hugh Warner. He has a real name. It's not Marilyn Manson. People keep calling him, hey, Marilyn Manson. He got a real name. But I'm sure he probably wants to be called Marilyn Manson anyway. But anyway, ladies and gentlemen, he has a long rap sheet. But anyway, look, we're going to get to the story of this Ashley, Ashley Morgan Smithline. We're going to get into the story, man. This story is crazy. I'm going to read the story to y'all. The chick is crazy. She is a crazy woman. If this is true. Now look, this is from Fox News. It says Marilyn Manson's ex, Ashley Morgan Smithline, details alleged abuse she suffered at the hands of rocker, already look monster. She's already calling him a monster. The Rockers ex included Dita Von Teese. Dita Von Teese was Marilyn Manson's first wife. And Evan Rachel Wood have also accused Manson of abuse. Evan Rachel Wood is an ex of his. She's accusing him of the same thing. Look, I told you, man, his ex-wife is accusing him of this craziness. This is crazy. Look at him. He don't even look rap tight. All right. Ashley Morgan Smithline claims rocker Marilyn Manson raped and abused her during their 2-year on and off relationship, believing she survived a monster. He lured me in with his endless intelligence, Smithline 36 admitted to People in an explosive new report, but his intellect allegedly hit a much darker, more violent side. And she claims he bit her, whipped her, cut her with a swastika emblazoned knife, and shoved his fist in her mouth during sex. Damn. Ooh, that's some kinky stuff, Marilyn. That's some kinky stuff, if it's true. That's some real kinky. And you let it happen? Smithline let it happen. You must really love him to let all that happen. You ain't reported when it happened, after that happened. You ain't reported. You ain't say nobody. Look, Marilyn Manson has me doing all kind of dangerous stuff in the bedroom. But now she's telling us now. Okay. She also claimed that before taking a road trip abroad, the Rocker 52 asked her to find Nazi memorabilia like knives and whips. Okay. I mean, it looks like the type that likes stuff like that. He kind of made it like, this is just a joke between us, Smithline, who's Jewish, told the mag. I think at this point, I was already coerced enough that I felt like he would not like me if I didn't bring those things. If I'd known the weapons were used on me, I think I would have felt a lot stranger. Smithline revealed that the first instance of Manson's alleged abuse involved him whipping her bareback as she lay face down and naked on his bed. Okay, I mean, it looks like the kinky type. It looks like a kinky guy. He likes kinky stuff. She also claimed he allegedly sexually assaulted her numerous times, adding that the first time she woke screaming to find herself tied to his bed, being penetrated by Manson. Oh, boy. Look, I see right here, look, another one of his exes right here. Marilyn Mrs. Laura says, Game of Thrones star, Aspen Bianco's sexual assault claims are probably, look, another chick, look, like I said, man, he got a bunch of women accusing him. Another chick, the Game of Thrones chick. His attorney says they false accusations. But let's see what happens in the courtroom. You know how the law is. They always turn their back on men. Anyway, he kept telling you can't rape someone that you're in love with, she said. Ooh, man. Mm-mm-mm. You should have came out before and let us know. That's it? Okay, is it? Come on, man. That's what am I missing? Am I missing something? Look at this guy. What am I missing? Ladies and gentlemen, what am I missing? This guy is crazy. Crazy. He is a crazy man. He's crazy. You get a relationship with this guy and you... Crazy. This guy's crazy. Any woman that gets in a relationship with this man, you've got to know you're going to be into some kinky stuff. You're going to be involved in some kinky stuff. You just thought he was going to go, you know, he was just a regular dude. This nothing about Marilyn Manson says regular. I wouldn't even want to be caught alone in the damn alley with this guy. That's how crazy he looks. And y'all are dating him. Somebody's even married this man. So look, man, Ashley Morgan Smithline, she did an interview about her abuse with this guy, about her abuse. And I wanna see what what she looks like in an interview. I wanna see if I can tell if she's lying in an interview. You know how sometimes you can tell if people are lying when they talking and telling a story? I wanna go into the story, man, because I think she might be lying. I think she might be telling a story on this man. So let's see, man. I wanna go into the story, man. I think it was yesterday she did an interview, man, with a live interview with People. So we're gonna see the interview and see how she looks. One way to tell a person lying is by their body language. People's body language says a lot can tell you a lot about a person, their body language, if they're telling the truth or lying. I'm gonna see if her body language lets us, let's just see anything. Marilyn Manson. When's the last time Marilyn Manson had a concert? I can't even remember the last time. Can't even remember the last time Marilyn Manson was in concert, man. But anyway, man, Marilyn Manson is a very talented artist, man. Very talented artist. He got songs out like the one I just played, man. Take the Love. What's the another one he had? Sweet Dreams. Man, what's another one? The Beautiful People. And what is it? I can't think right now. I think those are the only ones that come to my mind, man. But like I said, man, he's a talented artist, man. And I mean, he's been doing this thing for a while anyway. And since 1989, he's been rocking and rolling, man, doing his thing, man. But man, if this is it, man, it sucks. So anyway, look, I said, man, she did an interview with People, I think yesterday. I want to see if it was yesterday. So I'm going to go ahead and share it. Yep, yesterday, one day ago. Anyway, yeah, one day ago. More People. We're going to get into this, man. We're going to get into it and see what she got to say. I'm going to see if she let's see if she's lying, telling the truth. Let's see if she's lying, telling the truth. What is she doing? What's she going to do for us? What's she going to do? All right, come on. Let's go. Sometime, man, I'm in the woods of West Virginia, man. Sometime the signal be kind of slow. All right, come on. Give it to me. We want to see this chick. We want to see. All right, come on.
We all felt the same thing, guilt and shame. And being with these other girls,
that's the price you gotta pay when you move to the damn woods.
Guilt and shame have lessened. They're not going away. And I don't know that they will. And my feelings of dirtiness and wanting to wash that off. Gone away. And I really.
You wanna wash Marilyn Manson off your body, huh? You should never let him in your life.
Rock star Marilyn Manson is under investigation.
Several women have come forward in the past couple of weeks with similar allegations of abuse against the shock rocker.
As far as other fallout goes, he has been dropped by his record label, yes. CAA, his talent agency has also dropped him as well.
On February 19th, 2021, the Los Angeles County Sheriff's Department confirmed they were investigating allegations of domestic violence involving Brian Warner, better known as the musician Marilyn Manson.
Okay,
the
news came just weeks after nearly a dozen women,
including actress Evan Rachel Wood, shared allegations of abuse against Manson. According to the LA County Sheriff's Department, the incidents under investigation occurred between 2009 and 2011. Manson has denied the allegations, saying in a statement, quote, "These recent claims about me are horrible distortions of reality. My intimate relationships have always been entirely consensual with like-minded partners." To date, he has not been charged with any crime.
That's beautiful.
One of the women who came forward in early February was model Ashley Morgan Smithline. On February 1st, Ashley posted on Instagram accusing Manson of abuse, sexual violence, physical violence, and coercion. And now she's telling her full story for the first time.
I have bonded with the five other main girls who went through this, and we have found such a strength in numbers.
I bet y'all have. Our stories are all identical.
It's disgusting.
Comforting each other.
At least if you're gonna be an abusive psychopath, be original. And he wasn't in any way.
In 2010, Marilyn Manson was a 41-year-old heavy metal icon, as well known for his music as his extreme, often controversial persona, while Ashley was a 26-year-old model working in Thailand.
I grew up out here in LA in Calabasas. My parents are both in the industry, so I started modeling pretty young. I always wanted to act. That was my intention and my goal, but modeling monetarily came first.
Ashley had frequently worked with LA-based artist and photographer Tyler Shields, who also happened to be a friend of Manson.
A friend of mine, a photographer, Tyler Shields, had, shown me photos. And so he contacted me on the phone and said, who he was. And I again, like, I wasn't into that type of music. I knew who he was. I knew his public persona, but...
You were just trying to come up. Just say you were trying to come up. I won't believe you just said, I was trying to come up. I didn't really like his music, but I knew it was Marilyn Manson. He liked me, so I got with him because I was trying to come up.
I want you to be in a music video. And I was like, thank God, like, I can go do this. And he mentioned, like, you know, knowing a lot of people in film. And I thought I could finally get out of modeling, so. And especially modeling overseas. So I was in Bangkok and we talked for months. We would email, we would
get with Marilyn Manson,
Facebook.
You would make a name yourself being with that crazy looking guy. You don't like his type of music.
All we talked about was our favorite movies and our favorite books, and they were all the same. And we knew the same lines from the same movies, and he was so intelligent. And it, like, physically, I wasn't very taken at first, but he really lured me in with just this, like, endless intelligence. And it felt very safe. It felt very secure.
That November, after 2 or 3 months of communicating long distance, Ashley flew to Los Angeles and checked into a hotel on Hollywood Boulevard.
The reason I came out in the first place wasn't we were in love and we were friends, and he was casting me in something and I was gonna be able to act. But he flew me out, he put me up the Roosevelt, he brought his bottle of absinthe and had, like, cocaine with him. And he came with his assistant, which made it more comfortable. He came with a girl that was a couple years older than me.
Okay.
And we all, you know, hung out and had some drinks, and then, you know, he's like, can I kiss you? And he was still being so romantic and so kind and normal. I went to his house the next day. It was odd. It was a hollowed out ballet studio. Billy Zane, the actor from Titanic, had lived there before him. So he had a mural of Billy Zane on the wall. So as a ballet studio, there were big, like, open rooms. The bedroom was right when you walk in to the right. Everything was black, of course. And to the left, there was a glass sound booth. In the back, there was the studio. There was weird furniture. There was, like, mounds, like, big mounds of cocaine in every single room.
Oh, duh!
It was just, no, but that was how it was, and his absence.
That's what rock does! Rock stars do coke!
I guess, in boxes, you know. It was odd. Like, he was odd. I knew he was odd. Like, he looks odd. I didn't think I was going to, you know, like, leave it to Beaverland. I knew that he definitely, like, was darker than I was, but he didn't express any of that to me. Like, again,
I don't see any dark side to you.
I didn't listen to that kind of music. But slowly, you know, these things were slow. Like, the first couple nights we hung out, I was allowed to sleep, and he slept. And then it was little things that, like, you know, we were shooting, and all of the windows were blacked out, so he would lie to me about what time it was and tell me, oh, it's only midnight. And it was, you know, maybe 6 a.m, and it was light outside. And just the lies got more and more. Like, what I've read about getting someone into a cult is you deprive them of food, you deprive them of sleep, and you deprive them of talking to anyone. So, like, all those things were true. Like, if I would fall asleep at 1 a.m, he would start playing really loud music and wake me up, and then I had to go do a line of cocaine to wake up and keep partying with
him. Nobody make you do a line of cocaine, girl.
And more than that, give him attention.
I really don't think Marilyn Manson was like, hey, you better do this line of cocaine.
How wonderful he was. And he was, even when he was abusive, sometimes he would be joking and funny. And then sometimes he would be the most terrifying monster in the world. Like, he would say things like, do you know I could kill you right now?
According to Ashley, the verbal and psychological abuse soon turned physical.
The first time that he, you know, I didn't know that you could rape someone that you were in a relationship with. And There's a difference between waking up to someone having sex with you nicely in the morning and waking up tied up with someone having sex with your unconscious body. Like being tied up and screaming and not enjoying it, and him like laughing like sadistically. Or like, you know, gagging my mouth or something. And then we didn't really speak of it. I wasn't allowed to speak of it. I never stood up to him ever because I knew that would be more abuse, more torture. And I didn't want it. There was a time where there was like during a rape, there was a struggle and my nose broke and I flew back overseas. Like I threw through Narita, the airport in Japan, with a broken nose. It's not comfortable to fly 17 hours with a broken nose. I had a bridal shoot the next day, and I had bruises on my eyes. I looked terrible, and they said, what happened? And I said, I fell down, you know, like what any battered, abused woman said. You start telling lies, and then I just got, like I said, I was a light, happy, generous, caring, outgoing-ish person, and then I was a secretive, scared little girl.
All right, that's enough.
There were people there at the house, his band.
Hold on. What we got going on here?
Friends.
What we got going on here?
Our movie or the music video or whatever BS.
All right.
As people
start, we're done. we're done hearing with Ashley. Enough. I don't feel nothing from her. Did you feel anything? Did you feel it? Did you feel that she was telling the truth? Did her body language say anything to you? So she said she flew back to shoot. And if people notice, you know, her wounds and her, and all that stuff. Okay. So where are these people at? Can we hear from these people that you had the photo shoot with so they can say, yeah, she came in beat up with scars on her face, broken nose, all that? Can we talk to them? I don't know, man. I don't know, but all these women are claiming that Marilyn Manson is this crazy psychopathic, sexual abuser, mental, physical abuse. He's just a monster. Marilyn Manson got his hands full. He got his hands full. And like I said, he just got married in October. He had a private marriage in October. This is his second marriage. His first wife is claiming the same thing. When is the right time to come out and say you've been abused? When is the right time? 1 year, 2 years, 3 years, 4 years, 5 years, 6 years? It don't matter. As long as you still feel the pain, it's okay to come out and just and claim these, make these accusations on a person, right? It doesn't make sense, man. The law needs to change. Look, when these things happen to you, man, woman, child, whatever, you've got to come out as soon as it happens, because then It's hard to, you know. I don't know, man. I'm so done with this, man. I'm so done with this. But look, man. Anyway, man, Marilyn Manson got his hands full. Just got married in October. I don't see his marriage lasting much longer because it looks like she's gonna be like, oh, look, dude, you ain't gonna be doing a whole bunch of nasty, crazy stuff, cutting on me and beating me and all kinds of stuff. You're not gonna be doing it. You're not gonna have sex with me in my sleep. If that is true, these are all accusations. Marilyn Manson will have his day to prove his case. Like I said, man, men are not winning these cases. Men are going to prison. Men are going to prison. They are not winning these cases. I don't know. We got to eventually stand up and say, guess what? Enough's enough. We're tired. Men cannot keep having these allegations come up on us years later after we have relationships with these women or not have relationships with these women. Men gotta stand up, man. Men gotta stand up before it's too late. Anyway, man, look, man, this is Live, Love, and Laugh. I hope y'all enjoyed this story, man. If you are Marilyn Manson fans, tell me, like, what you think about this.